And welcome back to the final day of the Potato Expo here in Orlando, Florida. I'm Bob Larson with the Ag Information Network of the West. And joining me this morning is Keith Jones. Keith is the executive director of BPIA, which is the Biological Products Alliance. And you're a fairly new entity. And you tell us a little bit about what BPIA does.
Sure. Well, thanks for having me here this morning, Bob. So BPIA, we're the Biological Products Industry Alliance, and we're a trade association based in the Washington, D.C. area. We now have over 125 members, and our members are all companies that are involved with biological products. And when I say that, I'm talking about biopesticides and biostimulants, and those are just what they sound like. They're biological or natural products that either help with pest control or plant growth, including potatoes.
Sure, and as the industry, the biotech and the biochemical, biopesticide industry grows, there became more and more of a need for a voice, and as the, whether it's lobbying, whether it's just being out there and letting people know what's going on, that's where you come in.
Right, absolutely. I mean, we started about 17 years ago with just five member companies, and at that time it was just five biopesticide manufacturers, and they felt that they did not have a voice of their own on Capitol Hill, with US EPA, with USDA, so they came together and they formed the association, and as the industry has grown, and the industry has grown tremendously, our association has grown right along with it. I mean, the most conservative projection are that the biological product industry is going to continue to have double-digit growth. We're talking 14 to 15% growth for the foreseeable future.
And I would just, you, great segue here, because I was just going to ask, this is the demand is growing for this type of technology, and more and more companies are jumping on board.
Absolutely. As more growers become aware of these technologies and the efficacy of these technologies, and also the demand, there's consumer demand. People are much more concerned about what's on their potatoes than they ever, and on their french fries, or really all their food, what's on their lawn, what their children are being exposed to, what their pets are being exposed to. There's so much more awareness that that's generating a lot of demand.
Right. And tech part of all of our lives continues to grow, you guys are there to help people adjust as things change, and which is going to happen.
Right. I mean, a big part of what BPIA does is just education at all levels. We educate members of Congress. We educate federal government regulators, state regulators, the general public, and that's why we come to shows like this. I go to over a half dozen different shows around the country and actually around the world, just promoting and educating about biological products.
And right now, you'd say your biggest focus these days is?
We have so many focuses. I mean, right in D.C., there's a lot of legislative activity. We're looking at the 2018 Farm Bill and reauthorization of PREA, the Pesticide Registration Improvement Act. We have a big event coming up ourselves the week of March the 5th in San Diego, California. It's the BPIA 2018 Spring Meeting, but it's also an international symposium. So we'll have speakers and attendees from around the world, Europe, Asia, the Middle East, certainly North and South America, and they'll all be talking about biopesticides and biostimulants.
Well, Keith, hey, thank you so much again for joining us this morning, and we'll send it back to you on this last day of the Potato Expo here in Orlando, Florida. I'm Bob Larson with the Ag Information Network of the West.